we want to simplify the given expression, and I've listed the order of operations here on the right for reference. So notice the first step is to simplify inside the parentheses. So in this example, we need to determine the sum here first. So to do this, we'll write this vertically, lining up the corresponding place values. So we'll have 2.7 plus 0.5. Now we'll bring the decimal down into our sum and add as we normally would. So 7 plus 5 is 12, so we carry the 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. So this sum here is 3.2. So now we have 4.2 times 3.2 squared. Now we want to simplify the exponents, so we want to square 3.2. Well, 3.2 squared means 3.2 times 3.2. So let's go ahead and do that over here. We have 3.2 times 3.2. Notice how we have one decimal place here as well as here. Therefore, the sum must have 1 plus 1 or 2 decimal places. So now we'll go ahead and multiply and then place the decimal in the correct position when we finish. So we'll start by multiplying by 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 3 is 6. Now we'll multiply by 3, but we're going to put this in the second column from the right. So 3 times 2 is 6, so it'll go here. And then 3 times 3 is 9. And now we'll add. If we want, we can put a 0 here. 4 plus 0 is 4, 6 plus 6 is 12, carry a 1, and this is 10. So now we have to have two decimal places, so starting at the right, we'll move the decimal point two places to the left. So 1, 2, so this product is 10.24. And that should make sense because we know that 3 times 3 is equal to 9, so 3.2 times 3.2 should be a little bit more than 9. So 10.24 does seem reasonable for this product. So now we have 4.2 times 10.24. So we have one more product to determine. And to do this, it's going to be easier if we change the order of this. Remember, due to the commutative property multiplication, changing the order here does not affect the product. So when we set this up, we're going to have 10.24 times 4.2. Well, this decimal has two decimal places, and this has one, and 2 plus 1 is 3, so now the product must have three decimal places. Now we're going to multiply by 2, so 2 times 4 is 8, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 0 is 0, and 2 times 1 is 2. Now we're going to multiply by 4, 4 times 4 is 16, but remember the 6 is going to go in the second column from the right, so the 6 will go here, and we'll carry a 1. 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1, that's 9. 4 times 0 is 0, and 4 times 1 is 4. Now we'll add, and again if we want we can put a 0 here. 8 plus 0 is 8. 4 plus 6 is 10, carry the 1. 1 plus 9 is 10, carry the 1. 3 and 4. But because we have to have three decimal places, we'll start at the right and move left three places. 1, 2, 3. So this product is 43.008, or 43 8/1000. And again, this product does seem reasonable because we know if we had 4.2 times 10, it would be 42. So 4.2 times 10.24 should be a little bit larger. We'll take a look at another example in the next video. I hope this was helpful.